the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace and peace of God our Father, the love of his Son Jesus, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it, for we are Easter people, and Alleluia is our song. This gives us a reason, in spite of everything that is happening in our world today, to come together with hope, with joy, with faith. We hope to live this new life of Easter, but before we do, it's important for us to step out of the tombs of our sinfulness and pause to ask God for his forgiveness. Because we are all sinners and because we need the forgiveness of the sacrament of reconciliation, but are unable to receive it at the present time, let us begin this Mass by making together a perfect act of contrition. My God, I am sorry for my sins with all my heart. In choosing to do wrong and failing to do good, I have sinned against you, whom I should love above all things. I firmly intend, with your help, to do penance, to sin no more, and to avoid whatever leads me to sin. And if we make a promise to the Lord, then we will go to sacrament of confession as soon as we can, that we believe that our sins are forgiven. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins, and may he bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And now let us give glory to the Lord of life, who raised his Son from the dead.
Thank you.
Lord's day of his resurrection. We have told God that we are sorry for our sins. We have given him glory for the gift of new life. And now we join our prayers, our hopes, our dreams, with the prayers, hopes, and dreams of all God's people throughout the world. And together, let us pray. Lord God, on this day, through your only begotten Son, you have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, may through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light to the light of life. We make this prayer through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And now let us pray by listening for a moment to the words of the Scriptures that remind us that Jesus is alive, is in our world, and there is hope. Open our ears, Lord. Help us to hear your word. Open our ears, Lord. Help us to hear. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit. He went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible not to all the people but to us, the witnesses, chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness, so that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. "Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate this feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and she saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and she said to them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb. We don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out, and they came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down, and he saw the burial cloth there, but he did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb, and he saw the burial cloth there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and he believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. In the midst of the nightmare that we call COVID-19, it might be helpful for us to understand one of the most familiar images of Easter and understand why, in fact, it has become so popular since the 13th century. As far back as that time, Christians had used eggs that were dyed with bright colors and intricate designs to bring some of the joy, the happiness, and the peace of Easter into the lives of believers, especially at a time that was not always so happy like ours. The reason the egg was chosen to be a symbol is because of the struggle that a chick goes through in order to break out of its shell so they can live a new life. It has to pass from the security of the shell. It has to fight its way through that shell before it can live in its new world. Easter reminds us all that Jesus had to endure the struggles of Good Friday before he could rise from the dead, before there would be the victory that Easter is all about. Life after death, victory over struggles, hope after despair, and light after darkness. This is truly a message that our world so desperately needs to hear at this time. But we as believers cannot forget that this is also a message that challenges us as well as invites us to live this new life. We who are living through the nightmare of COVID-19 need to know that there is hope because there was an Easter. That one day we too will step out of this nightmare and into a new and better life because Jesus stepped out of his grave on Easter and promises us that we will rise too. This is the hope that will help us break through the dark cloud of negativity that we see all around us. A cloud of negativity, of solitude and loneliness, despair and hopelessness, confusion and fear, of an anger that keeps looking for someone to blame, an impatience that no longer looks for solutions or answers but demands them. And demands them now, right away. A growing sense that when someone doesn't think or act the way I do, then obviously they are automatically wrong, maybe even a little bit evil. There's so much of this going on in our world. This is the yeast of the old ways that St. Paul speaks about. And we're allowing these things to become more and more prevalent. And we have to begin to listen to St. Paul when he tells us to use the yeast that is the resurrection of Jesus. Easter reminds us that there is hope, but as long as this negativity continues, believers must still struggle and continue the struggle, because this is the challenging part of the Easter message. This is the challenge of the new life of a disciple, and this new life must be lived because he lives. Easter gives us the hope things may seem, there is always hope for a victory. But they need to see it in our lives, not just hear it in our words. We need to make the Feast of Easter more than a feast we celebrate, a miracle we believe in, a hope that brings life. Easter must be life for us, a life that we live every day. We celebrate today the fact that Jesus has passed from this life through the struggles and pain of Good Friday to a new way of life. He invites us, and in fact he needs us, to join him in this new life, because the tomb is now empty. He is no longer dead, and he wants to live. He wants to live in and through each of us. May the Lord, who rose from the dead on Easter, continue to live this new life because we have said yes to his invitation. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Another symbol that is so much a powerful sign of the Easter season, is a symbol of water. Water that was blessed last night at the Easter Vigil. Water that we call the Easter water, that has a special significance in our lives because it is a water that gives life, and hopefully it gives life to us. But also we celebrate this water because it reminds us of our baptism. On the day that we were baptized, promises were made for us by our parents and our godparents. And hopefully the parents and godparents gave us the example so that we might be able to live out those promises. But today, at every Easter, the Church gives us an opportunity to renew those promises and accept those promises for ourselves. So I ask you to think about this as we are asked basically what we believe.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth? We do believe in faith. of sins, the resurrection of a body, and the life everlasting.
Because we believe, we are able to reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises, because Jesus is alive in us. We are also able to do something that is most important, especially in this time. We are able to pray. Today is Easter. Today is resurrection, but resurrection is not a return to a former way of life, but rather a transformation in Jesus, in the apostles, and hopefully in each of us and in our world. Easter is a transformation to a whole new way of living. That all believers may be messengers of joy and hope to a Good Friday world that is filled with fear, sadness, illness, and hopelessness. That the church and its people may show in concrete and visible ways the joyful power of Jesus' triumph over the powers of darkness and sin. That Jesus' resurrection may give the church a renewed energy to bear witness to the message of new life and new blessing. That the fact that Jesus has risen will change lives and attitudes, renew families and communities, and bless our world with a new beginning. A new beginning that is so badly needed after the darkness of COVID-19 that has gripped our world. And that the resurrection of Jesus may bring joy to the disheartened, healing to the sick, hope to the downtrodden, eternal life to those who have died, and peace to all who mourn. Lord, on this truly wondrous day, you have brought a transforming redemption to a needy world. Grant us a new spirit of hope in our world, a new renewed faith in your presence to your people, and a lively love in all that we do. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. And now in joy, we go to celebrate the great gift of himself that Jesus gave us at his Last Supper.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we receive the bread and the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, let them become our spiritual food and drink. And now, as an Easter people, let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, exulting in your paschal gladness, we offer you this sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, Lord, but on this day especially, to praise you more gloriously, for Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He is the true Lamb who has taken away the sin of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, he restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Easter joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers and all the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of glory as together we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Lord, you are indeed holy and are to be glorified, for you love the human race and always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered here by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and he breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of his last supper, he took bread and he said, blessing. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again he gave you thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, that will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and we profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son and our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have now seated at your right hand, we proclaim the word of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the followers of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, Timothy our Bishop, all the bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and in his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, so that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. And we pray especially today for all the victims of the coronavirus, to their families, to those who are sick and those who have died, and especially those who minister to them. Grant also to us that when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Stanislaus Kostka and all the saints,
praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Now, as God's people, the people of the new life, the people of resurrection, we have the courage to raise our voices in song, and we pray today in a special way, in a song that hopefully is very familiar to you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
In this meaning, the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to those who receive.
This is the Lamb of God. This is Jesus who has come to take away the sins of the world. Happy and blessed are those that he's invited to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
one of the most painful parts of this Holy Week, this Easter, is the inability that we have of being able to receive the body and blood of Christ. Hopefully, you will have the benefit, once we are able to come back and worship together, that we will really begin to appreciate more and more just what this great gift is. That as we as Catholics believe, it's not just a sign or a symbol of anything, it is the real presence of Jesus Christ, truly present here on our altars every time we celebrate this sacrament of his love. So I invite you now to join me in this prayer for spiritual communion until that happy day comes when we can rise from the coronavirus and come back to new life in our churches and with one another. In the meantime, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in this most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot do this at this moment and receive you sacramentally, come and be spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the paschal mysteries, we may come to the glory of the resurrection. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. On this very special day, it's my hope that our celebration of this great feast of Easter may help lift our world out of darkness and the hopelessness that has engulfed us for so many weeks, and that it will soon bring us a spirit of new life and joy, so that we may learn from these experiences a new way of living, a new way of dealing with what has been a Good Friday world for all of us. I'd also like to thank Andrea Tai, Sarah and Kayla Franson, and Josh D. for being our technicians throughout all of Holy Week, who made this live streaming of Holy Week possible. I'd like to thank Nancy Dunn and the Igo family for helping us to decorate for our services. I'd like to thank Paul Giacomo, who came down during the week and planted spring flowers all around the church, in front of the church and around the buildings, to give us a sense of hope and new life. I'd like to thank everyone who reached out to me personally and offered me prayers and I'd also like to thank Argonne Catholic Press, the Benedictine Foundation of Vermont, and Gaither Music for permission to use their copyrighted music to enhance our celebration and to allow us to use it without any charge to us. I'd also like to thank all our new Facebook friends for becoming part of our socially distanced congregation. On this great feast of Easter, may God bless us all with his gift. Now let us bow our heads as we ask God for his blessing.
May Almighty God bless us through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend us from every assault of sin. May he, who restores us to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten Son, endow us with the prize of immortality. And now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may we who celebrate the gladness of this Easter feast, come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal life. And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, descend upon us all
and remain with us forever and ever. Our Mass is ended. Let us go and